his Netflix special will be filmed from his bedroom.
Yeah.
Then it's art. And your next comic, coming to the stage, here all the way from Chicago, Illinois, Caitlin Cooper.
Hey guys, last time I left the open mic, I saw a sign that said hot tub sale. And it was the Illinois State Fair hot tub sale. I guess in small towns, you guys just have sales for anything. The very next sign I saw, driving down the road, it said sale. And then it said Special Olympics. I hate to tell you, but I don't think those are for sale. I do a lot of field work. I got poison ivy pretty much up the entire right-hand side of me. I told my friend Brandon about this, and I was like, yeah, it's like pretty much my whole leg, all the way up my thigh, and then I have like a little bit on my chest and my stomach. And then I saw him a week later, and I told him, and he was like, how's the poison ivy? I'm like, it's doing better. He was like, how's the boob? Clearly, he had his priorities straight to the point as far as where the poison ivy ended up. We were doing field work, and normally we take SUVs, but this time I ended up with a truck. I got to drive this big truck. And I call them the overcompensation trucks. Does anyone know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. The, like, truck that they, like, rev their engine, and you drive by or, like, an asshole, and you're like, small penis. I'm not talking about the trucks with dents and with dirt. I'm not talking about the trucks where people work in construction. I'm not talking about the trucks where people walk on a farm. I am talking about these spick and span Chicago trucks where these people are clearly compensating for something they're lacking in life. I finally got to drive this truck and I was excited and I thought it was going to be like the commercials, like vroom vroom. And instead, the gear shift was like an air conditioning knob. And it was like, tink, drive, tink, reverse. I guess some of these guys just can't get away from having a small knob. I like to make fun of my dad because he's where I get most of my humor from, i.e. bad humor. When I told him I think I needed more fiber in my diet, he showed up at my apartment with a bottle of Metamucil and a shirt that said, this guy pooped today, so that's my thing. But my dad, I feel bad for him. He was raised with two sisters. He married my mom and had two daughters, so he really just couldn't get away from PMSing in general. He said on the phone today that me and my sister were being all hormonal at the exact same time that my mom was going through menopause and that his life was a living hell. Lo and behold, my dad gets prostate cancer and he's fine, no freak out yet. He had surgery, he had radiation, and the third treatment is he got put on Lupron. It's a medication that like ramps up your testosterone so it'll shut off entirely. It's basically chemical castration. So, the side effects to Lupron, as we found out, was mood swings, weight gain, acne, sweating, headache, general pain, hot flashes. So essentially, he's the one who ended up PMSing for two straight years, as if having a life full of women wasn't painful enough. In our family, we have renamed the Hallmark Channel, the Lupron Channel, because it is the only fucking thing my dad watches anymore. I'll come home in the middle of July, and it'll be some love story where it's like Christmas. I'm like, it's fucking July, why are you watching this? He's like, it's the Lupron Channel, it's the Lupron making me do it. It's just unfair. But I actually, when I got back from the field, I just wanted to feel human again, you know? And, you know, face mask, just do anything to, like, feel like I wasn't covered in mud and poison ivy. And so I went and got a haircut, and I got hair dyed, and I was thinking about how the dye got on my skin. And the last time I dyed my hair, I was, like, trying to find the Vaseline. And if you don't dye your hair, then you might not know, but Vaseline is something you, like, put on your skin around the edges of your face to prevent getting dye on your skin. And as I was looking looking for the Vaseline, I was like, where would I have left this? Where would I have stored this? I couldn't find it. And I realized it was in the pet bin, because the reason I had bought Vaseline was for expressing my dog's anal glands. If you don't have a dog, it's a lot like the prostate exam happening on my dad, except with my dog. And as I'm like applying the Vaseline to my face, all I could think was, God, I really hope I didn't like double dip. Thank you.
Caitlin Cooper, everybody. Do not ask to use her Vaseline. Or this next guy.